You think groups in Gaza have such, you know, precision and firepower? Really?
Seriously? Well, I don't think it was precise.
Seriously?
That's the point. If you look at the
it was.
If you look
it
at
was,
the
it was.
Ambassador, with
it
respect,
was.
If you look at the BBC, you look at the BBC investigation.
It was.
They include footage which seems to show a rocket misfiring. Let's have a look. There's no sound. You see it go up, and then you see a ball of fire, and it looks like, and this was the BBC's conclusion, based again on circumstantial evidence, that this was fired from within Gaza, it misfired, it then landed in the car park next to the hospital.
Yes,
now,
yes,
all I ask you is this, Ambassador.
Yes, I am an ambassador, I'm an official, and I tell you with certainty, this was an Israeli airstrike.
Well, where's your evidence?
I have the evidence, and you will see the evidence.
But where is it?
I'll tell you what's my evidence. My evidence is that we are calling for the Red Cross to come and investigate this and for the ICC. And until now, the Red Cross has the responsibility at such war crimes. Who's blocking the Red Cross? Anyway, we have very strong civil society, human rights organizations on the ground. We are communicating with them. Tomorrow you will hear from everybody.
This is very interesting, though. The BBC is a big news corporation. Right now, a lot of people are criticizing the BBC for not actually stating that Hamas are terrorists. But let's put that aside. The BBC has been around for years. Usually they are very serious and very thorough. So if the BBC are saying they verified this and that the attack happened within Gaza, in times of war, a lot of disinformation is spread. There's a lot of propaganda on both sides. So who really knows?
And human rights organizations on the ground, we are communicating with them. Tomorrow you will hear from everybody.
And you believe you will produce evidence that it was Israeli?
Yes, we will. Yes, we will.
Why would the American ambassador?
The question, Pierce.
Let me ask you this.
Don't ask me about the Americans. The Americans.
Why would the president of the United States say that his own independent investigation by his own people, i.e., not the intelligence given to him by the Israelis, that has also established it came from within Gaza?
Is that a serious question, Pierce? Really? You think the Americans are?
You think he's lying, President Biden?
Yes, he is lying. He is lying. And he is part of...
That's a big charge to make about the President of the United States.
He has just lied before getting any evidence. There is no way...
He's seen evidence.
I don't know if he's...
But to be fair, we all know Biden's kind of getting old, you know what I mean? Are we supposed to believe that Biden knows exactly what he's looking at? Because he's an old guy. And I'm not even trying to be disrespectful, but we all know Biden is getting up there in age. So I hope he wasn't the only person who verified this evidence, man, because I'm not entirely sure Biden is the greatest person to believe at this very moment in time, you know?
Getting any evidence. There is no way...
He's seen evidence.
I don't know if he's seen evidence.
Well, he said he has.
He doesn't have personnel. If he has personnel, he must provide protection for our civilians. Then he is complicit in the crimes against...
When you see that video, what do you think you're seeing, Ambassador?
It's whitewashing and gaslighting, as we have been seeing over decades.
What if you're wrong?
And, what if I am wrong? Bring me again here, okay?
Okay.
Bring me again here, and then we'll discuss it.
Okay.
No one has such firepower except the Israeli...
But have you seen the crater? Have you seen the crater?
...army. And you know what? No one even in the region has such firepower. Have you
seen the crater?
I have.
Does that crater not tell you it was not an Israeli airstrike?
You see, this is the trick. I'll tell you what happened. Israel did it. Israel thought the world was giving it the green light, that it was okay to do so. But when we did it, they did not expect the outcry. And then they did it again, as they do all the time.
Why is the crater so small?
As they do all the time, they simply go out and deny it, blur the lines, two stories, we don't know. And I will remind you, few weeks from now or few months, Israel will come out and admit it. But it will be too late. They will not get the condemnation.
I don't think they will.
They will admit it, as they did in the past. In the past, they have denied many things.
Have you seen the BBC verify investigation? Did you watch that tonight?
You know, the BBC is to be blamed for part of this.
Why?
Because the BBC just ran one day before that Hamas digs tunnels underneath hospitals. Primarily speaking, instigating the Israeli IDF, another indication that they did it, that they should go after hospitals, which is a war crime, as you know, very well defined. Now, what is the issue here? What is the main issue here? Is that all these lies that have been happening over the years are not challenged by you, Pierce. You and all the mainstream.
Well, that's completely untrue.
No, no, it isn't.
All that says to me is you've never seen me on air.
I have seen you. Well, I have seen your interview.
You saw me for years.
I have seen your interview.
You've seen me interview Netanyahu twice.
I have seen your interview just a few days ago with the Israeli ambassador. Mm. She did say here on this seat, mm. on this seat, that they provided the whole south of Gaza mm. as a safe zone, mm. and they are building shelters to Palestinian civilians. She told you that.
And I said
Did you challenge her?
I said that.
Did you challenge her?
I challenged her like this.
No, you did not challenge her.
Let me answer your point, Ambassador.
I'll tell you, my sister lives
She denied there was a humanitarian crisis.
She did.
I said there was.
No, no, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
You started that conversation with her with showing an outpouring emotions, good for you,
yes.
about the mothers. Why didn't you start with me about the thousands of mothers, grandmothers?
I literally...
Pierce is biased. He is biased. And I've been watching this daily. You guys have been watching this daily. Pierce is biased, man. Clearly, he's back in Israel. He's supposed to be a journalist. He's supposed to be a little more impartial. And that's what I try to do on this channel. I try to be impartial. But it does seem like Piers Morgan is somewhat biased towards Israel. And it is what it is. A lot of people are taking sides when it comes to this situation. But as a guy in the media, as a journalist, as a broadcaster for 20, 30 years, you should be more impartial, man. It's true, man. He wasn't talking about the mothers and the bloody sons and the daughters in Gaza. He's backing Israel completely. He was completely backing Ben Shapiro when he came on Piers Morgan Uncensored.
The mothers. Why didn't you start with me about the thousands of mothers, grandmothers,
I literally read that.
With me.
Well, Ambassador.
This is the asymmetry.
Ambassador.
She lied with you.
Let me be clear.
And she said that the south of Gaza right. is safe. You know how many people were killed in the south of Gaza mm. only in the last 48 hours? Mm. You know that my sister now, she lives in the south mm. of Gaza.
I know.
And you're following my Twitter. Mm. Look at my nephew, Ammar. You saw Ammar.
Yes.
You saw what happened to Ammar.
Yes.
They live in the south. So an Israeli official sits here and tells the world mm. that the south of Gaza is safe and people should go there en masse, mm. therefore ethnically cleansing these people to the south to slaughter them. Mm. And then you, Pierce, do not look her in the eye and tell her, stop lying. Mm. I was on the BBC Sunday morning just a couple of days mm. ago. With the foreign secretary and others. Before me was another Israeli mouthpiece, mm. spokesperson, Mark Regev. He said, we did not and will not target any mm. hospitals. Mm. They lie all the time.
Yes, but just to be clear, on the hospital, there is a clear, circumstantial set of evidence, which has been established now by the BBC, by the independent verify unit. They don't have any skin in this.
You think that was the first time Israel targets a hospital, Pierce?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just talking about last night's atrocity, which is what it is, because hundreds of people have died. There remains a massive question mark over whether Israel had anything to do with it.
What about the other 2,800?
Well, let me come to this. All right.
Let's be honest. A lot of dead Palestinian children, mothers, fathers, sons. When you're comparing the casualties, who has the most casualties? It's probably Palestine. And I think that's the argument he's making. Piers Morgan is not really sympathizing with the Palestinians. He's not really sympathizing with the people of Gaza. And that's sad. And that's very sad. Especially as a broadcaster, man. You shouldn't be doing that.
To do with it.
What about the other 2,800?
Well, let me come to this. All right.
Let's
come to this. So I want to take you back to October the 7th, because you were very quick last night when you believed it was an Israeli airstrike that had committed this horror, which had killed several hundred people. We're not entirely sure of the exact death toll yet, but certainly hundreds of people appear to have died. You were very quick to demand that everyone from Keir Starmer to others publicly condemn what had happened.
Of course.
So let me take you back.
Of course.
Well, hang on. Let me take you back to October the 7th.
Don't play this.
No, play I'm not this. Playing anything.
No, don't play this. Don't play
if
this.
If you are in the...
No, Ambassador, let me finish my question. Okay, I know where you're going, but I want to explain.
I don't think it takes a genius to work out where I'm going.
I wanted them to
condemn... But let me ask a question first,
okay.
Then you can respond, please.
Okay.
Okay? My question is this. You're very, very keen to demand that political leaders, including Sir Keir Starmer here, publicly condemn
yes.
an attack on a hospital which may not have been Israel,
yes.
right? And you repeated that throughout your evening on Twitter, right?
That's true.
But what you are not prepared to do yourself as the ambassador to the UK, because mm-hmm. I've checked your Twitter feed and you've not done this, and to my knowledge, you've not done this in public, you're not prepared to condemn Hamas for the slaughter of 1,400 innocent people in Israel on October the 7th. So I give you the chance, given that you want others to condemn acts that kill people, even if they're not responsible, given that Hamas have brazenly admitted responsibility for what they did, are you prepared to condemn it?
You know, this game and this narrative...
It's not a game.
It's a game.
Why?
I'll tell you
why. Should you demand condemnation of people dying, but not be prepared to condemn it yourself?
Allow me to explain it to you and to your viewers why it is a game and a very vicious, unfair, asymmetric game that has contributed to the oppression of my people for 100 years. Mm-hmm. Number one, you know our position. You know that Hamas is just a militant group that was created 20, 30 years ago.
Is it the terrorists?
You ask me this question? Okay. What is the definition of terrorism?
Well, I'll just ask you.
What
you think
is the definition of terrorism?
The UK government.
I'll give you the international United Nations definition of terrorism. It is the unlawful use of violence against civilians to terrorize them for the sake of a political agenda. Mm-hmm. Agreed? Mm-hmm. Agreed? Unlawful violence against civilians. Mm-hmm. Do you? And answer me, please.
Well, no, I've asked you a question.
Do you consider Israel to be a
with respect, I'm asking you
a terrorist state? Do you consider Israel to be a terrorist state?
Ambassador, if you won't answer me, why should I answer you?
Did we agree on the definition of terrorism?
I've asked you, is Hamas a terror group?
Israel has been targeting civilians in front of your eyes for 75 years.
But why should I answer any of your questions if you won't answer mine?
It's playing a game, though, isn't it? He makes a fantastic point. If we're taking the definition of terrorism, attacking people unlawfully, civilians unlawfully, and we all know what's been happening these past few days with the airstrikes. We all know what's been happening. All these bloody innocent civilians have died in Gaza. Do Hamas. If you're going to call Hamas terrorists, you have to call Israel terrorists, too.
Civilians in front of your eyes for 75
years. But why should
years,
I answer any of your questions if you won't answer mine?
Deliberate targeting, and not just this round, 2014. You know all that happened. 2005.
I'm very aware of the history.
Okay, then you
I've
are
been
aware.
Very critical of
is
Israel.
Is Israel a terrorist state?
I'm asking you the question.
Is Israel a terrorist state?
Ambassador.
Well, this is the asymmetric.
Ambassador.
Answer me and I'll answer you about Hamas.
It's not how this works.
No, it is.
It's my show.
It is.
And you're and a guest on my show.
It is. From now on, this is the way it works.
Okay. But
there has to be equity and
ambassador,
symmetry.
Ambassador, you are the ambassador to the United Kingdom.
We are equal. I'll ask you a question.
You are the ambassador.
I am. Proudly so. I'll ask you a question.
And you've been here, I think, since 2018.
Yes.
You've been ambassador for 5 years,
yes,
right?
And I was in the US before.
Right. And the UK government has Hamas identified as a proscribed terror group. Do you agree with that?
That's the UK business.
You don't agree?
No. This is not about me agreeing or agreeing. I'd like the UK to designate the Kahanist in the Israeli government as a terrorist group.
You may want other groups designated.
As a terrorist group. I want to see
But as the
equality,
Palestinian ambassador, do you disagree with Hamas being prescribed as a terrorist group?
Get my point. Please, get my point. Mm. I want to see equal treatment. And I will accept the equal rules. Mm. If these rules are applied on the Israelis, I would raise my hand and accept it.
Okay.
I will put my hand on my heart.
Let me say this to you.
Do you consider Israel to be a terrorist state?
Let me say this to you.
That's number one. Number two, I'll ask you, do you accept the UK? You asked me about the UK government. The UK designates Palestine as the occupied Palestinian territory, right? OPT. We are occupied. Do you accept that designation?
Well, it's an interesting question about occupation, isn't it?
That's your government.
I think the Palestinians have lived in a very repressive...
So it's not occupation?
Well, it's a repression, right?
What?
They are living.
You don't
as,
accept international.
They are living consensus? As repressed people. I have for years.
Oppressed by what?
Well, they're oppressed by Israel effectively keeping people trapped in Gaza, right? And they have the ability, as they've shown in the last few days, to turn on and off food supply. I think all this is wrong.
What about the West Bank?
Ambassador, I think it's all wrong.
But he admits it. So he's basically saying, yes, these Palestinians are treated awfully by Israel. He's admitted it. You got to give him props there. Right now, he's trying to be a little more impartial. You got to give him props there.
Okay. To turn on and off food supply. I think all this is
what
wrong.
What about the West Bank?
Ambassador, please. I think it's all wrong. But let me just ask...
No. This is a major point. It's
you're
a major
not interviewing
point.
Me.
Is it an occupation?
Ambassador, you're not interviewing me. But what you're trying to do, if you don't mind me saying, you are distracting from my original question.
It's a conversation.
Respectfully, Ambassador.
It's a conversation.
I was interested that you last night were demanding that political leaders like Keir Starmer condemn a supposed attack by Israelis on a hospital, which now looks like it wasn't by Israelis. And I'm simply saying to you...
You keep repeating
if
this.
You want
parroting this.
Ambassador, let me finish my question.
How do you know it's not by
Israelis?
I don't. How do you know?
I don't.
So don't say it.
But nor do you.
Oh, I know what I'm saying. I represent the situation.
You do not know so it was an Israeli airstrike.
You hold me accountable next time. You're neutral.
Okay.
You're neutral.
I am neutral.
I'm not neutral.
Okay, I get that.
So, no. Okay. You are being biased.
That is honest of you.
You are taking the Israeli side.
No, I'm not.
You are.
I'm not saying...
You are following the cue from Israel.
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I'm saying the BBC Verify unit has said tonight, do you think they're impartial in this or not?
They shouldn't. This is
they won't even call Hamas terrorists.
This is none of their business. This is the business of Karim Khan, the prosecutor.
I'm going to ask you one more time, and you don't have to answer this question if you don't want to. It's entirely down to you. But given that you, last night you wanted people to condemn what happened last night, in your belief that it was an Israeli airstrike, and you were ferocious in demanding that repeatedly,
yes,
will you now take the opportunity to condemn what Hamas did on October the 7th? Final, I only ask you one more time.
22 Arab states convened at the beginning of this, including my state, my government, and they condemned...
Do you personally condemn it?
They condemned the killing of civilians from all sides.
Right.
You know what?
Not all sides. No,
from all sides.
Do you condemn what
from
happened
all
on October 7th?
Yes, yes.
Why are you so reluctant to condemn it?
You asked.
You were the one last night demanding...
But to be fair, he just admitted it. He just hasn't admitted it within the confines of what Piers deems a proper answer. But man just admitted it. He basically said all sides. All sides means Hamas and Israel. Right? Come on, man. He did just answer the question.
Why are you so reluctant to condemn
it? You asked.
You were the one last night demanding people condemn things.
I'll tell you why. I would be the first to condemn. If I ever saw you asking an Israeli official to condemn, did you ask the ambassador to condemn all the atrocities?
I will be asking.
I'll tell you.
I will be asking the representative of the ambassador.
No. You had the ambassador before me. You did not ask her to condemn anything.
Then you didn't watch the interview.
I did.
Yeah.
I did.
Okay. Let me ask you one more time.
I did.
Because I'm not sure if you heard my question.
I will not answer this question unless you allow me to explain.
No, that's fine. You don't have to answer it.
No, I'll tell you.
But if you're not going to answer it, don't demand that other people condemn things.
No.
And certainly don't ask me to condemn things.
Yes.
If you won't condemn 1,400 people being slaughtered...
Our position.
How can you not condemn what they did?
Our position is very clear. I represent the Palestinian leadership and people. I represent the PLO. That's the sole legitimate... representation of the Palestinian people. President Mahmoud Abbas, the government.
I know.
Hamas is not part of the government.
I know.
Okay, that's number one. Number two, that legitimate representation I represent have committed for 30 years for first non-violence and negotiations. I belong to that camp. You're asking the wrong person. Committed to international resolutions and committed to the recognition of Israel. We recognize the state of Israel long before anyone else. And we still waiting for Israel's recognition of us. And guess what happened in this 30 years? Every political avenue was blocked. Every legal avenue, like the ICJ and the ICC, is blocked. Every hope for any Palestinian is blocked. You are talking to a person who religiously believes in nonviolence. So please don't ask me that question.
If you believe in nonviolence, Ambassador, why are you reluctant?
I answer.
If you believe in nonviolence,
that's why I picked the
why
policy.
Why are you so reluctant
that's
to
why I wanted to become an ambassador?
The worst
because
terror attack
I believe in the power. I believe in the power of diplomacy. I believe in the power of nonviolence.
Okay.
I believe that we should always return and maintain the moral high ground. But that's why I am answering the way I'm answering.
Okay, I understand.
That's why I'm challenging you.
Okay,
because the moment I accept your question is the moment I accept we are the instigators of violence. We are the aggressors. Mm. And I asked you the question before.
She didn't say that.
No.
I didn't say that to you.
But you're inferring that.
We are the aggressors. And I asked you the question before.
She didn't say that.
No.
I didn't say that to you.
I
understand you're not part of Hamas.
No. Not me. Not me only.
I understand
the entire Palestinian people are the instigators.
I understand you're not.
The question.
I understand you're not Hamas.
Let me explain, Pierce, please.
But I understand it.
Cool down. The moment I accept this logic of condemnation, in the lack of Israeli officials being asked by you and everybody else to condemn, that moment I accept that my people are lesser of a people. That we are not equal, that we are a lesser of a, children of a God.
And I don't believe that.
I think.
And I think Palestinian people are absolutely entitled to fairness and equality and human rights, many of the things they've been deprived of for decades.
The moment
I would love to see peace in the Middle East, but nobody can show me how what Hamas did on October the 7th has done anything for the Palestinian people other than set everything back and make peace even more unlikely.
The moment I see that equity, that balance, Yeah, I'll be the first to use any word you want. Mm. But so long as there is this imbalance, mm. this racism against Palestinians, mm. this consideration of us, of being, you know, one-fifth...
But I'm
you
not racist against, you know, Palestinians.
No, no, I think there are people who are racist. I think anti-Palestinianism is flourishing everywhere. Mm. I think we are seen as to be less of value than the Israeli lives.
Let me ask
you I'll tell you how. I'll tell you
no,
what.
No, that's real. I agree with the guy. All media outlets, not just mainstream media, but even peers as well, from the very beginning... He's just been asking everyone to condemn Hamas. Like, he's clearly biased towards Israel. It's clearly.
I'll tell you, seen as to be less of value than the Israeli lives.
Let me ask you.
I'll tell you what. You brought me here. You're bringing everybody. This has been the focus of everyone. Mm. You have located your moral compass on the 7th of October.
No, no.
Did you locate your...
No, no.
Did you locate your moral
all
compass?
All that says to me is...
Did you locate your moral compass I on covered, the 200 people killed this year in the West Bank?
I've covered...
Did you bring me to discuss the many Palestinians
to,
who were killed only in the last few months?
Ambassador.
This is the... Let me try and respond to you. Okay.
I've been a journalist for 30 years. I've run major national newspapers. I had a daily show at CNN for 4 years. If you actually go back and look at what I did, including, for example, a two-year campaign against the Iraq War, which I thought was an illegal invasion of a Middle Eastern country. So please do not pigeonhole me as somebody that has no compassion for Palestinian people. No, no, don't generalize.
You oppose the war.
I've been getting Palestinians on all week. I've been giving Palestinians platforms, including you, all week, right?
But when Israelis were harmed, you see, this is what I'm telling you. Why didn't you bring Palestinians when hundreds, thousands of Palestinians are killed by settler militias?
Ambassador, here's my answer.
Yeah.
I can guarantee you, absolutely guarantee you, that if the Israelis ever carried out a terror attack of the nature we saw on October the 7th...
They are doing.
What, they
since
killed...
Since 1948.
They pulled Holocaust survivors out of their homes and kept them hostage. They shot babies in their cribs.
Watch the terminology.
They burned families alive.
Terminology.
Deliberately going in to get civilians.
You see, your responsibility is to really use the right terminology here.
Why? This is indisputable.
All of the words.
All that happened.
You are invoking many things here. You've just invoked terrorism. You are now invoking ISIS.
You don't dispute it was a terror attack, surely.
You are now invoking ISIS, and you spoke about...
I haven't mentioned ISIS, but for the record...
You did.
Not with you, but for the record...
With everybody.
I do believe there's a parallel between what Hamas has done...
That's criminal.
...on October the 7th and ISIS.
No. Okay, you see...
You don't agree?
The Israeli... Look, what happened on the 7th of October is not condoned. Mm. We reject wholeheartedly the targeting of civilians. Yeah. Our culture, our upbringing, who we are as Palestinian Christian and Muslims, what happened is non-Palestinian. Mm. How is that? And we reject it. And we want to continue maintaining the moral grounds of our cause very right.
Let me ask you this.
Okay, let me continue.
Yeah.
Let me continue.
Okay.
However, since the 7th of October, mm. The first moment, Israel started preparing and putting together a huge campaign to delegitimize the Palestinian people, to link Hamas to ISIS, and then link Hamas to the Palestinian people, then link the Palestinian people to ISIS, then do the ethnic cleansing and the mass destruction and the mass murder you are following on your
screens.
Okay, that's exactly what happened. Then the international media, mainstream media, were literally following the cues. ISIS, you talked about Iraq all the time. ISIS is a group of criminals who gathered from all over, mercenaries who were there to kill and only to kill with no real agenda. You agree?
Yes.
You think Palestinians are that?
No.
Don't you think we have a political and legal case to make?
But I think
so why are we using these terms?
Ambassador.
We are using these terms to allow the Israeli war machine to kill en masse.
Let me respond.
That's why we're using.
Let me respond.
So everybody who uses these words is complicit.
Ambassador, let me respond.
Everyone.
Let me respond.
Okay, respond, please.
I do not believe that most Palestinian people support what Hamas did on October the 7th. I do not believe you do. I do not believe the Palestinian Authority does. So do not think for a moment that I think you're all the same.
Okay.
I think Hamas is a terror group who committed an act of unspeakable depravity and terrorism, and they must be held accountable. The question is, what is an acceptable way to hold them accountable? I do not believe a full ground invasion will do anything but make this 10 times worse, for the record. But let me ask you this. There are 200 hostages, I think 199 hostages being kept by Hamas. Should they be released?
Yes.
They include children, they include Holocaust survivors. What is your view?
All hostages should be released. First of all, they should be kept safe and protected, and they should be released, but hostages from all sides.
How do we get to peace here, Ambassador?
We have 5,000 hostages in Israeli jail, including children and women.
Let me ask.
We have many of them.
Okay, you made your point.
Who are rounded there without charge or trial.
Let me ask you,
everybody has to be released.
I've got to wrap this. The final question. How do we get to peace from here? It seems to me, after 30 years of covering this conflict, we've never been further away from peace between Israel and Palestine. How do we get to peace here?
By listening from your heart and your brain that this is a people struggle for 106 years. 106 years because it all started here. Mm-hmm. The Balfour Declaration by the British Empire, where they promised our land without consulting us, and they turned us in that 67 words into non-Jewish minorities. We were 98% of the population. We had lived there for millennia. We were the cradle of civilization. We produced every prophet. Palestine is the birthplace of Christianity. We were literally the hub of the region, the linkage between Europe, Asia and Africa, and all of a sudden we are only a non-Jewish minorities. And then Britain took over our land, and not only they denied our peopleshood and nationhood in 1917, but they denied us during the mandate our statehood, because the contract with the League of Nations was Britain will come and take mandate of Palestine to prepare us and to recognize us as a state as Palestine. You know what happened in the Nakba and the mass expulsion, Jewish militias at the time, ethnically cleansed two-thirds of our nation, including my own parents. So
I know the history. I have great sympathy, with what happened to Palestine.
Since then, my people, 67 and the military occupation that we discussed, since then, this is a people struggle for freedom, for justice, for equality. This is a people's cry to survive.
How do we get
this
to peace?
This is by full application of international rules. We did not create the post-World War II
two-state solution.
Yes, of course, Israel has to end its occupation that began in 1967. Refugee rights must be respected in accordance with international law. Two neighborly countries can get together with neighborly relations, but the Palestinian people have the right to defend themselves and a state. We don't have an army. A state has an army. A state will do so. So occupation is the root cause of all this discussion.
I have to end it there. We've had half an hour. I appreciate you coming in. Thank you very much. I understand the passion. As you say, you're not an impartial person in this. I understand that. And I wish your family all the very best in Gaza. I mean that very sincerely.
Thank you.
I hope they're okay. Thank you. Thank you for coming in.
Shout out to Piers. He did show him respect and love at the very end there, just hoping that his family are safe. That was another powerful, powerful, powerful interview. The ambassador raised a lot of interesting points. If we were to believe the definition of terrorism, one could argue, I'm not trying to trigger anyone, the Israeli government, of course, not the Israeli citizens, but the Israeli government are acting like terrorists. When you think about all the airstrikes killing all these average, everyday Palestinian citizens, including children, when you think about that, one could argue that the Israeli government are acting like terrorists. The thing about the bloody rocket that supposedly originated from Gaza, I'm not even sure about that. Apparently the BBC have verified that yes, it came from Gaza, so it's likely that it was Hamas. You know, in times of war, disinformation, propaganda, all of these things are widespread in times of war. So who really knows? My personal opinion, it could have been Hamas. It could have been an accident. But that doesn't change that at the end of the day, Israel has the firepower. Israel, all these crazy airstrikes, killing all these everyday citizens. Who has the most power right now? Who's enacting the most violence right now? You have to be honest. It is Israel, so fantastic interview. I feel like the Palestinian ambassador represented his people very well. Even though, you know, Piers, he gets a lot of criticism. Even I criticized him. But shout out to Piers for actually showing the guy love at the very end. You know, he kept it professional. And that's all you can really ask for.